Hello and welcome to your new engineering student orientation. The purpose of this orientation is to familiarize you with the college's administrative and academic processes so that you will be able to progress in your engineering studies more efficiently. First, a little background on the college. We are called the FAMU-FSU College of Engineering because we take students from both Florida A&M University and Florida State University into our program. Students enroll at the university of their choice, which we refer to as your home institution, and complete all of their liberal studies, math, and other core courses on that campus. All engineering courses are taken at the College of Engineering campus. When you graduate, your degree is awarded by your home institution. Florida A&M University was founded in 1887 and is the only historically black university in the state university system of Florida. FAMU enrolls over 12,000 students from the United States and more than 70 other countries. Florida State University was originally established in 1851 as the West Florida Seminary and went through several iterations before becoming the Florida State University in 1947. It now enrolls over 40,000 students representing every state in over 130 countries. The FAMU-FSU College of Engineering was established in 1982 by the state legislature as a joint program serving two universities. The college is a leading academic institution with excellent records of achievement in research and public service. We are widely hailed for taking the initiative to create programs to align academic curriculum with industry needs. The College of Engineering has five academic departments offering 18 degree programs at the bachelor's, master's, and doctoral levels. There are eight possible undergraduate majors and six different degree programs offered in our five academic departments, including Bachelor of Science degree programs in Chemical, Civil, Computer, Electrical, Industrial, and Mechanical Engineering. We offer the Biomedical Engineering major through our Bachelor of Science in Chemical Engineering degree program and the Environmental Engineering major through our Bachelor of Science in Civil Engineering degree program. All of our undergraduate degree programs are accredited by the Engineering Accreditation Commission of ABET Incorporated. ABET Incorporated is the recognized accreditor for college and university programs in applied science, computing, engineering, and technology. It is one of the most respected accreditation organizations in the United States, providing leadership and quality assurance in higher education for over 75 years. All of our programs and policies are designed to maintain this accreditation. The following section of this orientation will help you become familiar with some of the academic requirements of being an engineering major. First, all our incoming students, whether new freshmen or transfer students, begin as pre-engineering majors. The amount of time spent as a pre-engineering major depends on how quickly a student completes the four pre-engineering course requirements. Once those requirements, which we will introduce in a moment, have been completed successfully, you may request that your major be changed to one of the undergraduate majors that we offer. After completing the requirements of that particular major, you graduate. There are four courses that comprise the pre-engineering curriculum. These are the first year engineering lab, Calculus 1, Calculus 2, Chemistry 1 if you're a potential chemical or biomedical engineering major, or Physics 1 for all other branches of engineering. Students who enter the College of Engineering with all of these requirements complete, with the exception of the first year engineering lab, are eligible to take this online orientation as you are doing in lieu of taking the course. You must, however, pass the quiz at the end of this presentation in order to receive credit. All courses in this sequence must be completed with a C or better to receive credit. You are allowed one repeated attempt out of all four courses, and you must maintain an overall GPA of 2.0 or better. Any pre-engineering student that needs more than six letter-graded attempts to pass the four pre-engineering courses will not be permitted to continue into an engineering major. There are no exceptions to this policy. You may wonder, if I'm not supposed to repeat more than one course and cannot continue if I have to repeat more than two, what happens if I have to repeat exactly two courses? If you fall into this category, you will be considered for your chosen engineering major only after satisfying additional course requirements. The additional requirements vary depending upon the major you have chosen. You can find out more by speaking to an engineering advisor. Our next section will cover some important academic policies and procedures that are in place at the College of Engineering. You are encouraged to pay close attention to these and to seek out the Engineering Student Guide on the website listed above, since we will not cover every policy in this presentation. Due to the joint nature of our college, many policies may differ from those of your home campus. First of all, you may often have administrative forms that require a dean's signature for processing. You may obtain a dean's signature by going to the Office of Student Services in room B111. If you have not already done so, it is very important that you sign up for an engineering email account. This is our primary means of communication with you, and we disseminate important information, deadlines, and so forth on a regular basis. So it's also important that you check this email at least weekly. To set up an account, you may obtain an authorization form from the Office of Student Services in B111 and take it to the Communications and Multimedia Services office in room A332 to set up your account. Class attendance is imperative for you to succeed in your challenging engineering courses. However, sometimes things happen that cause you to miss a class, and your professor may require official documentation of the circumstances in order to excuse the absence. The Office of the Associate Dean and Student Services will issue excused absence forms when you can verify justified circumstances for the absence. The circumstances under which an absence may be excused include participation in a university-recognized or required event, personal illness that's certified by a physician, a job interview, or some other documented emergency. You are still responsible for working out the details of any makeup work with your professor, as the excused absence does not excuse you from completing any missed tests or homework. When the time for final exams arrives, the College of Engineering exam schedule will not necessarily follow that of your home university. You are responsible for checking your syllabus and the final exam schedule located at the link above on the engineering website. Non-engineering courses will follow your home university schedule. In the event that an engineering exam conflicts with a main campus exam, the engineering exam must be rescheduled. You, as the student, are responsible for contacting your engineering instructor as soon as you become aware of the conflict, and this should be well before exam week, in order to set up an alternate testing schedule. Moving on to course prerequisites, in order to register for a course, you must achieve a passing grade, which would be a C- or better, in all courses listed as prerequisites for that course. If you see a course listed as being a co-requisite, then you need to have either completed that course or you must enroll in it during the same term. If you do not follow this policy, you may be dropped from the course at any time and no refund will be provided. If there is an error in your final grade at the end of the term, contact your instructor immediately. All grade changes must be made within one calendar year. The College of Engineering does not assign plus and minus grades for undergraduate engineering courses. You must earn a grade of C or better in all engineering courses, although one exception may be granted with the permission of the department chair and dean. As mentioned earlier, some academic policies will differ between your home campus and the College of Engineering, and one example of this is our semester deadlines. First, if you're not doing well in a course, you've taken on a load that's too heavy, or you need to drop for any other reason, you should take care of this before the end of the seventh week of classes. Please note that while you are permitted to drop for any reason during this time, your financial aid and excess credit limits could be affected. Courses dropped after the end of the seventh week and before the deadline set by the College of Engineering are considered late drops. You will be limited in the number of times that you can late drop a course. During the time that you were a pre-engineering student, or if you were classified as basic division student by Florida State, you may have a grand total of 2 late drops. Once that limit is reached, you will not be permitted to drop after the 7-week deadline again until you have declared an engineering major. Students who have officially declared an engineering major and who are no longer classified as basic division will be limited to 3 late drops. Make sure to pay careful attention to the College of Engineering drop deadlines each semester, as they are not always the same as either home university. This policy applies to all of your courses, not just engineering courses. To review, a late drop is a course that's dropped after the seventh week of classes and before the late drop deadline set by the College of Engineering. The late drop deadline is typically the end of the 10th or 11th week of classes. If you are a FAMU student, this is different from your main campus policy because your non-engineering peers can late drop up to 5 times at any point in their academic career. As an engineering student, you get 2 late drops as a pre-engineering student and 3 as when you are fully into your major. You cannot bank your late drops. If you were an FSU student, this is different from your main campus policy because your non-engineering peers have a late drop period that extends to the 12th week of classes. The College of Engineering deadline is always earlier than your main campus. This pertains to all of your courses, again, not just engineering. So what happens if you fail to drop a course by the College of Engineering deadline, but something happens that's beyond your control that causes you to do poorly in a course? That is where the retroactive course drop or withdrawal deadline comes in. If you end up receiving a D or an F in a course because of a medical emergency, death in the family, military service obligation, or some kind of administrative error, you may file an appeal to be considered for a retroactive course drop or university withdrawal. Your request must be made within 1 calendar year of the original course attempt. For example, if you did poorly in a course during fall 2017 and you did not meet that semester's deadline, you have until fall 2018 to apply for a retroactive drop. The College of Engineering has a committee made up of engineering faculty members who review these appeals for retroactive course drops or semester withdrawals. They meet once per semester, so you must file your appeal by the semester deadline to have it considered. Appeals are filed online at the College of Engineering website, and you need to be able to provide supporting documentation to back up your request. You are not guaranteed a positive response, but the committee will review all documentation carefully to make their decision. Appeals will not be approved because you weren't aware of college deadlines, didn't manage your time wisely, or just had bad luck. Contact us at the email above if you need more information. There are many other policies that cannot be covered in detail during this presentation. These include the engineering course repeat policy, readmission to an engineering major, summer residence requirement, the procedure to withdraw from the university, the fact that FAMU engineering students cannot use grade forgiveness, and the student grievance and grade appeal procedure. Please review the student guide, which can be found on the College of Engineering website prior to taking the online quiz. If you were looking for scholarships, you should always start with your university's Office of Financial Aid, and you can also search the web yourself for funding offered by private industry. But the FAMU-FSU College of Engineering does offer a limited number of scholarships and fellowships to qualified engineering students from both universities. You can find out more by going to the engineering website and looking for scholarships under the Quick Links section. For many of your questions about academic policies and procedures, academic advising, administrative forms, and so forth, visit the Office of Student Services in room B111. We're here to help you access all the resources you need to help you navigate your college experience. If you have any kind of learning or physical disability or suspect that you do, visit the Disability Resource Center on your home campus. They provide testing services and letters of accommodation that will help your professors work with you in the event that you need slightly different accommodations in order to succeed. If you were in need of counseling services, both universities offer counseling centers where you may receive the support you need. This concludes our presentation. Please review the handout, the student guide, and any other resources provided prior to taking your quiz. When you have completed the quiz, contact the Office of Student Services in room B111 to change your major out of pre-engineering. Good luck!